DDL Triggers in SQL Server. Hi, I'm M. Asif Hussain from KnowHow Academy. What are we going to learn in this video? We are going to learn what are DDL triggers, how to create DDL triggers, how to alter the DDL trigger, how to disable the trigger, how to enable the trigger, how to drop a trigger using SQL Server. So at the end of this video, you could able to see this creation of a trigger and how to alter the trigger in SQL Server. So watch till the end. When I'm talking about a trigger, okay, we generally have heard the word called trigger, right? Whenever we hear the word called trigger, we can able to imagine few things that we know. But the trigger that I am talking here in SQL Server is something which happens when the event occurs. So now what is the event here? For the DDL trigger, we have the DDL events such as create, alter, drop. These three are the events. Whenever we are trying to create a table, the trigger will be fired up. Whenever we are trying to alter a table, a trigger will be fired up. Whenever we are trying to drop a table, a trigger will be fired up. So now we have to understand is that the three different types of triggers we have, which is DML, DDL and logon. So DML triggers, which is data manipulation language, in that we have insert, update and delete events. Now under DDL, we have data definition language and the events are create, alter, drop. So if we talk about these triggers, the difference between the DML trigger and the DDL trigger, this we have to understand. The difference between DML trigger and the DDL trigger is that DML trigger will be created on a table, DDL trigger will be applied on the database or on the server. To repeat back again, DML trigger is created on a table, DDL trigger is created on a database. So now let's go and see how we have to create a DDL trigger. So for that, as you can see, we have create trigger, trigger name on database. So now why am I writing this TR here? We need to write the trigger names with TR. It is not mandatory, but it can be used. The reason is that when we write the name with the TR, it indicates that that is a trigger. So now I am creating a trigger for what event? For create event. That's why I have written it as create trigger. The name is your choice. Either you can write any name of your choice. This is a convenient name that I have used it, right? So on database, for what event? For creating a table. As you begin the statement, whenever we are beginning the statement, we are ending it at the last, and in the middle we have the trigger body. We call it as a trigger body. Now in the print message, whichever the message you would like to put it, you can happily use that message here. So now what happens is that once if I create this trigger, when I'm trying to create a new table, this message will be shown in output that the table is created. All right. So let me show it to you. First, let us execute the trigger that we have created. I'm clicking on execute. Let me connect to the server. As you can see, the commands completed successfully. The trigger got executed successfully. Now I would like to create a table. Create table, table name, some XYZ with a column ID, data type integer. Now I am trying to execute this one. Once I execute it, you can see that we have a message. Table is created. Okay, so we have this message of coming up here. All right, now this particular example I have shown it to you for creating a table. Now in the same way, you might have a question. Okay, so for creating a table, we have used this one. Is it possible that for creating a table, for altering a table, for dropping a table, for these three, can we create a trigger at once? Yes, it is possible. We can create the trigger for these three at once. For example, Now I have created this trigger for creating a table. Who knows, someone might come and use the alter and do some changes in the table. Someone can come and use the drop and do some changes in the table. So to avoid all these, so let us create the table for, let us create the trigger for these three events at once. So as already I have created the table here, so what I'm doing, I'm just using alter for the same table name. On the database, I would like to apply it for the three events, create table, alter table, and drop table. My dear viewers, please understand one point, that we have to write the complete word create table. You cannot just leave it by writing create comma alter comma drop. No, we have to write create table, alter table, drop table, the complete word. Then I'm writing as I'm beginning the statement with some trigger body and with the end message. So what is this end message telling me? The table is created, modified, and deleted. So let's go and execute this one. Commands completed successfully. I have executed it. All right. So now what I am trying to do, let me go and alter the table. Okay. Alter. What table? The table XYZ that I have created. Alter table, table name, add column. I'm adding a column. What is the column? Let us take the column called name. The data type for it is varchar with the size. Okay. So now when I'm trying to execute it, it has given me a trigger message that the table is created, modified, and deleted. Am I right? Okay. So very interesting point is that we have the option to write whatever the message we would like to show in the output in the print statement, that we have to denote it in a single quotation, that we have to understand. Now, okay, you have seen how to use this trigger for all these three events. Now, if you would like to prevent the access, if you would like to prevent the users to do some changes, to do some modifications for your table in the database, then we just need to add rollback. Okay, so that if any changes is happening, it will undo it. Okay, we will get it back. So for that, what I am doing, let me alter this trigger with the trigger name on the database for the three events of DDL command as begin. Now I am writing the rollback statement so that I can get the information back. I am printing with some message and with the end as a last point. Now when I am trying to execute it, commands completed successfully. Now let me go and try to drop the table that I have created. Drop table. Table name is what? XYZ is my table. Drop table XYZ. If I am trying to execute it, we can see that the create alter drop table is not possible. Okay, the transaction ended in a trigger because there is a trigger applied to this particular database. So you cannot do these three events here. All right. So what's it's happening? It is not possible. And the transaction ended. It is aborted. All right. So what's happening it is, as we have created the trigger for this one, it ended up in a trigger and it showed me the message what we have it in a print statement. So this is how you have to create a trigger with the three events. Now, if you want to disable this trigger, then we need to just write disable. What you need to disable? You need to disable the trigger with the trigger name. What is the trigger that we have? This is the trigger name that we have. Am I right? I'm just copying it. I'm pasting it here on database. Where do we have this trigger? We have this on a database. Okay. So now when I'm executing it, we can see that the commands completed successfully. This trigger got disabled. The same trigger, if you want to enable it, just you need to write enable. Enable the trigger with the trigger name on the database, then again it will be enabled. Now, if you want to remove this complete trigger itself, you want to remove this itself, then what we have to write? Drop. Okay, we have to write drop. I'm executing it, right? So even what you can do is that you can come to Object Explorer also and you can see it. So for example, if I come here in this database, if I refresh it, okay, if Okay, we have it in a master that we have created. Let me refresh it. So on that, if we have any triggers created, so here also what we can do is that we can enable or we can disable the trigger. So let me show it to you. So here, let me go and create the trigger. Now in the Object Explorer, if I refresh my trigger, so I'll go to the database trigger and we have the trigger created. So we can right click it here and we can disable it. This is also another way. Or we can go and delete it. So this is the delete option that we have to delete the trigger from the database. So either you can write the query by writing disable trigger trigger name on database, or you can go and use it manually. So this is how DDL trigger works in SQL Server. So thank you for choosing KnowHow Academy as your source for IT knowledge. We are always here to help you to navigate the tech world. If you have any questions, do not hesitate to reach out. It's been a pleasure sharing this information with you. Stay curious and keep learning.